first at 10 tonight. Deadly basketball fight. A Hinds County deputy under arrest and charged with murder.
Jackson police say 25-year-old Justin Griffin got into an argument with Joshua Adams, an off-duty deputy at a basketball game. When they went outside to settle their argument, someone hit Griffin, causing him to slam his head into the concrete. Tonight, his family is speaking out. 16 WAPT's Tammy Eswick joins us live from where it happened. Tammy.
That's right, ladies. This is the incident scene right here in this parking lot where the deadly incident took place. And tonight, family members demanding answers. They want everyone accountable for that incident locked up.
Our boy was not a thug. You know, we raised our kid, and he was a good kid. And them thugs that was supposed to protect him, they killed him.
James Griffin, the father of 25-year-old Justin, breaking down as he talked about the death of his son. Justin, a youth basketball coach, died one day after getting in a fight with off-duty Hinds County deputy Joshua Adams.
If you can't go to a basketball game, come on, say, where can you go?
Police say it started as an argument during a Sunday morning basketball game here at the Mississippi Basketball and Athletics Gym, spilling into the parking lot afterward. Jackson police arrested Adams Monday, charging him with murder. The Griffin family pastor says he's grateful for the quick police action, and he wants the truth to come out.
The sheriff has moved fast, the chief of police has moved fast, and we thank them for that. But there's some things that's been covered up. There's some other people that's been involved, and we want everything in the open.
Pastor Pickett's son, Julius, was a close friend of Griffin and a fellow coach. He says he saw the entire fight.
The man comes out behind him. You know, he's saying something to him. I don't know what he's saying. And he goes to grab Justin by the arm. Justin pulls away like, man, what you doing? Why you grabbing me? I didn't do anything to be grabbed. You know, and, you know, I step in between at that time, you know, like, man, what you doing? You know, y'all ain't right. And then the other guy goes to grab him by the neck from behind. You know, he never says a word. It's the deputy with his uniform on. When he pulls away, here comes the referee guy. He comes at him. Now, what are you supposed to do when another grown man come at you? You back up in defense. And that's what he did. And when he hit him, I pull out my phone and begin the video, and I see my friend hit the ground.
Now family members say they want justice, and all those accountable, charged too.
No mother should have to hear that when her child was on the ground, not breathing, nobody helped him.
Yeah, and you heard it right there, that close family friend saying that he witnessed the entire incident and actually caught some of it on cell phone video. He says he plans to share that with police. Live in Jackson, Tammy Eswick, 16 WAPT News.
Tammy, can you tell us how that family is doing tonight?
Well, of course, we talked to the family around 6 o'clock tonight, Stephanie, and the daughter says they're all in good spirits. They're relying on their faith to pull them through this really tough time, as you can imagine.
Okay. All right, Tammy Eswick, thank you.